This video highlights multiple beam path options in the Sutter Instrument Multi-photon Movable Objective Microscope. Please note that the table optics shown here have been simplified. The main imaging beam path for multi-photon microscopy on the Sutter MOM runs along the table, up through the periscope, and into the scanning mirrors. Then it is scanned by either resonant or galvanometric scanners through a scan lens and a tube lens before going to the head of the microscope. Our three-photon movable objective microscope also uses the same main imaging beam path, but with a custom scan lens and tube lens for transmitting the longer wavelengths. Then the moving head of the microscope positions the beam through the objective and onto the sample. Once the sample is illuminated with excitation light, the emission light is collected by the objective and reflected to the detectors with a dichroic mirror. The PMTs in the detector will collect the emission light, whether it's a two-channel detector with 2-inch collection optics as shown here, or an alternate short-path 2-channel detector, or even an optional 4-channel detector. Two separate laser beams can be arranged on the optics table with individual Pockels cells and recombined into the system as well. In this case, the two beams can be independently modulated by the software for simultaneous multi-line excitation, fast photo manipulation, such as optogenetic stimulation, or molecular uncaging. On the other side of the microscope, the optional wide field path provides additional ports for even more flexibility. This path conveniently accepts an Olympus BX51 vertical illuminator mounted to the system to facilitate the use of fluorescent filter cubes, eyepieces, and a camera. This is particularly useful for quick focusing or finding your position on a sample before laser scanning. Excitation light is brought in through the rear port of the vertical illuminator and then reflected to the sample through the use of excitation filters and dichroic mirrors, allowing full utilization of wide-field imaging modalities. Several of our customers have even utilized this port configuration for projected pattern stimulation with a digital micromirror device. Alternatively, the vertical illuminator can be removed altogether for direct beam access to the relay optics that can direct a beam to and from the sample. And finally, this path can be modified as a secondary detector pathway to include a range of other detector types, such as IR cameras and spectral detectors, for example. Now, what about modifying the internal beam path of the microscope? It turns out that accessing the beam path directly between the scan lens and the tube lens is also possible. A common example is to utilize a polarizing beam combining cube to couple a second beam into this position. A second set of galvo scanners and a scan lens can even be added to control the scanning of this beam to perform site-specific stimulation from a secondary laser. This is particularly useful when a stimulation beam needs to be limited to customizable regions of interest within the field of view, independently of the imaging scanner system. Finally, two additional laser beams can be added to the system between the actual scanners and scan lens via a scan lens dichroic input. There is an engineered location to accept dichroic mirrors to couple one or two more light sources into the scan lens. This allows the added beams to be completely independent of the scanner system while still utilizing the scan lens and tube lens pair to project the photo manipulation beam spot on the sample. This allows for a simple setup using pre-aligned or manually controlled stimulation points within the field of view for easily implementable single-cell stimulation. Designed for flexibility, the movable objective microscope is easily modified. Will you need to stimulate many cells? Will you discover that you need to image deeper with three-photon imaging? Or will you develop and test a novel optical technique that has never been tried before? The many flexible beam path options on the Sutter Instrument Movable Objective Microscope make it the best open-platform multi-photon system to provide such downstream flexibility to match your dynamic research needs.
Please call us or email info@sutter.com to discuss system configurations tailored to your research. Additional product information is also available on our website. Explore our YouTube channel to find our latest support videos and product announcements. Subscribe now.
Please refer to our beam alignment tutorial for more detailed information about aligning the table optics of the imaging laser.